The next topic of section 2.1 is circle. Circle is defined as a set of points that are equidistant from a fixed point. That fixed distance is named as the radius of the circle and the fixed point is named as the center of the circle. Let's suppose this is our fixed point, and circle will be defined as the set of points that are equidistant from this fixed point. That is, if we take the distance of any point on the boundary of the circle from the center, it will be equal to the radius r, which is a well-defined number or the given defined number. So let's now we are going to derive the equation of a circle. For this, let us assume that we are having a circle centered at a fixed point hk and with the radius r. Let's suppose xy is an arbitrary point of the circle. Let us assume that xy be an arbitrary point of the circle. Then we know that the distance between these two points must be equal to the radius r. So applying the distance formula on these two points, the difference of the x coordinate plus the square of the difference of the y coordinate. So x minus h whole square plus y minus k whole square root is equal to r. Taking the square on both sides, we get the standard form of the equation of a circle. So it means if you are given with the center point and the radius, you can easily find out the equation of a circle. As in exercise 2.1 question number 23 to 28, you are given with some center point and radius and you have to find out the equation of the corresponding circle. So here in question number 24, we are given with the center point to be origin 0, 0 and radius is equal to 6. We just need to do that we will put the value of the center, that is hk, over here. X minus 0 whole square plus y minus 0 whole square, and r square means 6 square, which is 36. So x square plus y square is equal to 36 is the equation of the required circle. Here we would like to mention unit circle. Unit circle means centered at origin with radius 1. So when we find out the equation, it will be equal to x square plus y square is equal to 1 for unit circle. So you must know what is meant by unit circle. In next question number 26, we have center point at minus 4 and 2 and radius is equal to 5. So what we are going to do here, h is equal to minus 4, that is x minus minus 4 is now going to be x plus 4 whole square, and k is minus 2. So y minus 2 whole square is equal to r square, that is 25. You do not need to open the squares, it is just the general form. So x plus 4 whole square plus y minus 2 whole square is equal to 25 is the equation of the required circle. Next, in question number 55 to 60, we have to do the opposite work. That is, now we are given with the equation of a circle and we have to find out the center and radius of the circle. But in the previous one, we were given with the center and radius, we were finding out this equation of a circle. But now, equation of circle is given to us and we have to find out the center and radius of this circle. So we know that here the equation is given to be x square plus y square minus 2x minus 10y is equal to 55, but right now we are not able to find out the center or radius because we know the general form of the equation of circle is this: x minus h whole square plus y minus k whole square is equal to r square. And if we are able to put the equation in this form, then we can easily find out the center and radius of the circle by comparing it with the standard form of the equation. So now what we are going to do, we will try to shift our given equation in this form, that is the perfect squares of x minus h and perfect square of y minus k. So what we are going to do, we are going to apply completing square method so that we may complete the square of x and y, and then we will compare it with this equation. So if we just remember or go through the completing square method, the coefficient of x square must be 1, and then we divide coefficient of x by 2 in order to get the value of b, and then we add the square of b on both sides of the equation. So this is what we do in completing square method. So the same we are going to do over here. The coefficient of x square is already 1. For the value of b, we are going to divide the coefficient of x by 2. So 2 divided by 2 is going to be 1. So we are having 1 square over here, and in order to balance the equation, we must have add 1 on the other side as well. Now for completing the square of y square, the coefficient of y square is already 1. The coefficient of y is 10, so dividing 10 by 2 we will get 5. That is, we need 5 square in order to complete the square with y square. So 25 on this side and plus 25 on this side as well in order to balance the equation. Now x square minus 2x plus 1 is going to be x minus 1 whole square. y square minus 10y plus 25 is going to be y minus 5 whole square, and adding all these terms we get 81. So it means we have transformed our given equation with the help of completing square method in the standard form of equation of circle. So now comparing these two circles or these two equations, h will be equal to 1, k will be equal to 5. That is, the center point has x coordinate to be 1 and y coordinate to be 5, and r square is equal to 81 means the radius is going to be 9 in this case. Next, exercise 2.1, question number 51 to 53. You are given with 2 points x2 and 3 and minus 3, and you are given with the distance between them as well. You have to find out all possible values for this coordinate x. So in question, you have to find out all possible values of x such that the point x2 is 4 units from 3 and minus 3. It means we are given with the distance which is 4 units, and we have to find out the distance between x2 and 3 minus 3. So applying the distance formula on these two points, x2 minus x1 whole square, x minus 3 whole square plus 2 plus 3 whole square root is equal to 4. Simplifying this equation, we get x minus 3 whole square is equal to minus 9. Taking square root on both sides, we are going to have a complex number. It means there is no real number which is going to satisfy the required condition. Next, exercise 2.1, question number 31 and 32. In question number 32, you are given with this graph, and you have to extend the graph in order to, it is going to be symmetric about x-axis only. So you know that symmetry about x-axis means it, we must have a mirror image about x-axis. So it must be the same about this line. So here we have drawn the graph or extended the graph in this form so that we may able to observe the symmetry about x-axis only. For symmetry about y-axis, it must be extended in this form. Here we go. For symmetry about origin, what we are going to do, we are going to extend the graph. If it is in second quadrant, then obviously it must be in the fourth quadrant with the same shape over here. And for x-axis and y-axis both, it must be extended in this form, and it must be extended in this form as well. So this is in question number 32. That is, you may be given with a graph and you may be asked to extend the graph to observe the symmetry. Please note the questions from exercise 2.1 that you have to solve only odd number of questions.